Same, mate.
Back to you, bro.
Back to you, bro. I appreciate it, bro.
Bro, what's mine is yours.
Yeah?
Yeah, what's mine is yours.
Can I have that beer?
Yeah, can you have a sip?
Cheers, man.
It is mine now. I'm fucking hungry, eh? Bro. Bro, I got a little kebab for you. I'm glad you mentioned that. There you go. Cause,
oh, fuck.
That's all yours, bro.
I can always count on you for a fucking kebab, eh?
Bro, I've got you, bro.
There's a bite taken out of it already.
Bro, you know I get hungry. You know I can't, bro. You know I can't go 45 minutes without at least having a kebab. Bro, fuck off.
Nah, you can have it, bro.
Thanks. I didn't want to really give it to you anyway. It's fucking good, bro. There's extra garlic, bro, and extra chili. Yeah. Rock hard, bro.
I just want to give you a quick story on how me and Remy met. I was down in Sydney because my boss sent me down there for work. I was fixing some rich dickhead's fucking deck. And, I went out to the pub for a couple of schooners afterwards, like I do usually. She was pretty hot. I mean, if she's a 3 at 10, then she's a 10 at 3. Well, fucking. I was sitting there at the pub having me schooners. She was touching me up a little bit. I'm like,
I saw it, bro. Her hand was fucking, like, in his pants, like just jerking him. It was fucked up. I was, what's going over there? Are you there like a race? Like, I was like, get me in there, bro. I wanted to join in, but, you know, Aussie cunts, weird, bro.
Yeah, so anyway, she was full fucking tugging me under the table. I don't blame her. I mean, she's only human. Turns out, she had a man. And her man was a fucking big burly beast of a thing. About 6'7", big.
Dickhead, with the orange beard.
Yeah, real big dickhead. He was a fuckhead.
Fucking
he was a proper fuckhead. He come up to me and he's like, what are you doing with my missus? And I said, bro, she come on to me, you know. Fucking shit escalated quickly. He pushed me. I fucking stumbled back into this bar.
I'm enjoying the show. This dumbass over here hits me, knocks my drink, and spills my kebab. I was like, bro, take a step back before I fucking wreck you. He said, sorry, mate, have one of my schooners. Didn't mean to spill your beer. It was this dickhead with the ginger beard. I said, all right, don't worry, bro, cuz I got you. I smashed the schooner in about 3 seconds, cuz, you know, I'm a fully sick unit, bro. Got the glass. Smashed it over the ginger beard's face. He went down like a sack of shit, cuz he's a bitch. Fucking never since then, bro. Best mates. Fucking best mates. Best mate, yeah. Best mates, bro.
He lives up in Sydney most of the time when he's not on the run from his missus.
Bro, I had to take her fucking car today, bro. She was up me about not paying for child support. I said, listen here, bitch, that is not my kid. He looks fucking Asian. I'm not Asian at all. Fuck him. It's yours, Remy. Fucking pay the money or you fuck off. I said, fuck you. See you later, bitch. I took her keys. Fucked off out of here, bro. I'm up in, what's this fucking town called, bro?
Armadale,
bro. Where the fuck am I? I'm in the middle of fucking nowhere, bro. What the fuck is this?
Bro. Fucking right behind you, that's God's country.
Right. What lives here? God, where are you? You fucked me on two births last week, the horses and the dogs, and you fucked me on both. Well, right now, just fucking cat. Almost fucked up my watch, bro. Keep my kebab spewing, bro.
You know, we're actually we're the highest city in Australia.
You're drunk.
That's a little backstory on how me and this dickhead met. I'm gonna show him around the property, show him what it's like living a rural life.
Colleen, bro. Because the ladies love a clean mouth. Straight. And a dirty cock.